I'm going to show you how to make a snapshot photo freeze frame effect using PowerDirector. Who got some snaps on the snaps? I have a clip of a young lady on track one. She's modeling, got the Beyonce breeze flowing through the hair and all of that. We'll start off by creating a freeze frame for the photo. So we want to move our playhead to a position where we want to take that photo. And once we have our playhead on the position, you want to click on the snapshot button. Want to go to the location where you want to save the snapshot. Give it a name. And then you want to click on save. Now we want to place that snapshot right where we created that picture. So we're going to go ahead and click on split. We're going to go up to the snapshot that we created, hold down our left mouse button, and we're going to drag it right to that split. We'll let it go and we'll pick insert and move all clips. We want the snapshot to be 3 seconds long, so we'll click on duration. And we'll type in the duration and hit enter on our keyboard. Now we need to create the camera flash. So we're going to go to the transition room. And we're going to go down to glitch. And we're going to go to flash. We'll hold down our left mouse button and we'll drag this down in between the first clip and the snapshot that we created. And we'll let go of our mouse. We want to change the duration of this, so we're going to click on duration. And we're going to change it to 10 frames. And we'll click on OK. Next, we'll add the camera sound effect. So we'll go back to the media room. We're going to go to sound clips. We're going to go to work, home, daily life. And we're going to scroll until we find camera 01. We're going to hold on our left mouse button and we're going to drag it right underneath the transition. And we'll let go of our left mouse. We'll place our cursor at the end until we see the two arrows pointing in opposite directions. Hold on our left mouse and we're going to trim this so that it's the same length as the flash. And we'll click on trim only. Now we want to add the viewfinder to the video clip at the beginning and the video clip at the end. So we're going to click on media content. And this overlay I got from a site that I use for royalty-free footage. You can find one online or on YouTube for free. If you want to, I'll leave the link to this one in the video description. So I'm going to hold down my left mouse button. I'm going to drag it down to the beginning. And I'm going to place my cursor at the end until I see the two arrows. Hold down my left mouse and I'm going to trim it to be the same length as the first video clip. Now we need to add a blending mode because right now it's just black. So I need to get rid of the black using a blending mode. So I'm going to right click on this camera overlay. I'm going to go to edit image. I'm going to go to set blending mode and I'm going to choose lighten. And if I move my playhead to a different position, now you can see through the black of the overlay and you can see the model. And so it looks like you're looking through a camera viewfinder. So we need this to be under the second video clip as well. So I'm going to right click on the overlay. I'm going to go to copy. I'm going to click on the second video clip. Then I'm going to click on track two. I'll right click and I'll do paste. And paste and overwrite. And now you can see that we have the overlay on top of the other clip. I'm going to place my cursor at the end until I see the two arrows. Hold down my left mouse and I'm going to trim this in so that it's the same length as that clip. Next, we want to add some movement to the shot. So we'll double left click on the picture in the middle. And we're going to add a position keyframe and a scale keyframe right at the beginning. And we want to move our playhead to 2 seconds. So I'm just going to type in 2 seconds and hit enter. And then here we want to go ahead and change the scale to whatever scale you want. And we want to center her so you can change the X and Y positions that you need. And then we want to go ahead and move our playhead to 3 seconds. And here we'll go ahead and change the scale back to 1. And we'll change the position back to 0.5 for the X and for the Y. So what that's going to do is going to scale up and zoom in, and then it's going to go ahead and go back to its original position. So now you can go ahead and click on OK. And let's go ahead and play this back. Photobomb! This is just one example of what you can do with snapshots in PowerDirector. If you want to use a snapshot to make a time freeze effect, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.